arms. Bring your arms up. What time did the discussion forum finish last night?
Well, we waited until Sally left the room and...
Oh, the only bit nasty. Oh, the only bit nasty.
increases, thank you.
And then the other side waves. And backwards, with caution. It is crowned this place. It's a lot easier without 8 weeks at school. I go forward again.
Forward now, the squire, who will lead us into.
Morning, everyone.
Morning.
I decided I'd put my kit on so that you could just see how our dances are influenced by our kit. As you know, Strain Up have a ladies' side and a men's side. The men's side was formed 25 years ago, and the ladies 24. The ladies started off by joining in with the men, basically, and I think they were, they used a lot of Ducklington, which you'll see in the dance I'm going to do, is influenced by Ducklington. Stroud ladies really have, yes, they're Cotswold dancers, but they don't have any traditional, we have two traditional dances, I think, in our repertoire, otherwise all the dances are made up dances that members of the team, or either individually or as groups, we've worked out. First dance I'm going to show you is one called Joe's Jig, and it's actually a dance that probably a lot of you are just so bored of seeing me doing, because it's the only jig I know. No, I've increased that by one, actually, but...
Doubled.
But what is good about Joe's Jig is that, yes, it can be danced as a jig individually, but we generally do it as a threesome. And then, of course, it can be multiples of three, which is brilliant. So it's one of those very versatile dances. So it's probably best, I think, perhaps I just show you the dance now, and then we'll break it down and get into groups of three and break it down and go from there.
We'll stick with a plan that worked out late last night. I'll join in for a little bit, but dancing it as a Ducklington dance might have been.
As we were saying last night in our discussion, actually, it's very difficult. I was thinking, yes, where will the musicians stand? I mean, obviously, I want to be, you know, facing the audience. Don't want my back to the musicians. So the musician's going to stand sort of in front of the audience.
Well, I
know it's
locked, but they'll move.
Sympathy.
He's only a musician, after all.
Come on.
for general stepping style and so on. And those slopes.
Can we ask what colour your bloomers are?
I'm glad they're not brown.
No one knew what they were doing last night up in the loft. They're late for breakfast.
I'm also, of course, the ladies usually have bells on, but I decided we'd have a peaceful demonstration.
Right on.
Most fast stepping for most of our dancers is two doubles, four singles. Okay, that dance had a variety of steps in it, but the first step that I did is a step that we call a gypsy step, which is why I was having so much difficulty with all this business. No, but I just wanted to do a gypsy step. Right, so if you get into group of three, and and then the first figure is two double steps forward.
Okay. Thank you.
Remember on the
do it again.
Powerful way of having a
I have to dance these things. I can't.
You've done the foot up.
Oh, sorry.
But there's that bit of music left. They go to a half.
That was your point earlier.
No, it is. It just hangs around. Hey, on side. It hangs around. Thank you.
Because they're not going to be there anymore.
Well, also, I think
well, they'll be
theoretically.
Well, we are thank you. last or something on it. At least twice you said it, and I said so. Thank you. Left to the
Thank you.
willing to dance Revolution.
Thank you.
whatever it is. Good morning. I'm Tim Radford. As you know, my musician today will be Cat Radford, my daughter. And when Adrian first asked me whether I would be able to come over again and do anything, we originally planned to do something I didn't do last time, which was what I call Scrambled Bampton. But as that normally takes at least 6 hours of work and it's very complicated, I don't think we can cram it into an hour and a half. So instead, I'm going to do something which started life in 1981, and it's the first, as far as I'm aware, wholly invented Morris tradition in North America. It started life being called Minneapolis on the Mississippi. The Mississippi runs through the city of Minneapolis, which is in Minnesota, in the central plains of North America. And it was created by Jim Brickweedy, who maybe people have heard of. He was the first person to do the American Morris newsletter, and dances with Ramsey's Brackets and Minnesota Traditional Morris. And he created it for a team of women called Bells of the North. Bells of the North. And they did it for a number of years, and then in 1993, a new team was formed in Boston, the Greater Boston area, called Commonwealth Morris League, led by Rick Moore. And they decided that they were going to use the tradition as their basis tradition. They made changes to it, and it became what I'm going to teach you today, which is called Minneapolis on the Charles, because the Charles River runs through Boston. So they made some changes. This is the only tradition they do, plus one other they do Withings. Now, I don't really have to talk Withings in here. I think their Withings is better than their Minneapolis on the Charles, but they are. So, Withington is a Gloucestershire village centre over here. So, it's, I have to say right from the very outset, I've never danced this tradition in my life. I've only been to a workshop where Rick has taught it. It was a week-long workshop at Sidmouth, at Pyman's Camp, so I do know a lot about it, but I'm pretty observant as far as Morris is concerned. I have danced it in practice, you know, playing around. So, there won't be any great demonstration, particularly as I have two very bad ankles, which means I can no longer really dance. So, I will demonstrate the double step and the single steps. It's a pretty simple, flowing, big tradition the way that they do it. They're known as being a pretty young, athletic side.
Bam, 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 bam sixes, and we'll try and do that in the foot up foot bend. You don't need to practice the step anymore, you get plenty of chance to do it. Now it may be easier to do all facing me. Sex facing me is probably going to be the easiest way. And think about how stepping has been, you know, you really want to try and be elevated. There's a move forward on the first double step, a double step in place, and then single steps coming back. Try and do it in a nice elevated way, with that nice upright body, head looking over the person opposite you, over the top of them, keeping those shoulders nice and square and straight. Remember, the hips and the shoulders have to move the relative distance off the ground the same. The hips don't try and go higher than the shoulders. Up through the spine. Right, once yourself, come in with a jump, double step forward, double step in place, single step back, and then you come to do the float turn. You jump and turn 180 degrees out, face down.
On the jump.
Okay? Maybe come forward a bit, because you're going to have to go down afterwards. Okay? Singles. Back to back. it for the other. So right foot lead, turning with the lead foot to turn 360, which would be left. Yes, which would be left foot. And then back on the other shoulder. Do you want to walk out first or try and dance? Walk it first, see how it works.
Thank you.
The next figure is rounds. Now, when I first went to North America and taught Morris, I said, right, now the next figure's rounds. And they said, what? I said, the next figure's rounds. And they said, do you mean rounds?
Singles, the turn continues.
then the other half of the hay, something. Normally what happens in Cotswold Morris, you do something, then you do a half hay, do something, and then you do a half hay hunt. This is opposite. You do the half the hay first, then you do something, then you do the half hay to the next position, and then you do something. Now, one thing that better feature is, the half hay, you change the orientation from the set from that way to that way. And the second half of the half hay, you do not go back home, you invert the set from its original position. Okay? Now it's very simple. It's very simple. Ends face out, which is up and down. Middles go left to between the ends. That is done in one double step. You now have the second double step to turn right. To face the opposite. You now pass right shoulders, cross and turn with a single, well, cross with the single steps. And then you jump, turn to the right. Remember, everything is right lead for the chorus. You've now done a half hay. You've now done a half hay. Yes, front jump again. Okay? That's, and then now you would do something in the dance. Okay, I'll tell you what it is, it's simple. All you do is one double step forward, one double step back, and then a furry caper, and then a feet together jump. So forward and back, forward, back, with single, with double, furry caper, and oh yeah, sorry, the arms in the furry caper is exactly the same as you do in a plain caper, exactly the same as you do in a single step. It's one of the things about the tradition is there's only two, essentially there's only three hand movements. And it is, this is the single step hand movement, this is the caper hand movement, and this is the furry caper hand movement.
Steps. Front turn.
in between the ends for you all to turn together. You're all looking at each other. You should be able to do that nice turn around. It's a matter of timing. I think it's more difficult for the people that are standing still because they're going from a stop position to a movement position. But you still have to do that at the lark. So let's try.